and it's at a length of 6,600 kilometers. Starts from Ethiopia and ends here in Cairo, in the northern Cairo, which is Delta. And as you can see, that is just a part of the Nile River. There is here on the right side. That is an island in the middle. So you see how wide it is beside the lane. It's really huge. Next to me, that used to be an aqueduct, which is like a bridge to transport the water from the Nile River to support the citadel, the Cairo citadel. You see that big mosque over there? That is Muhammad Ali Mosque, and it built inside the citadel. Okay. Later on, when we reach the citadel, I'm gonna give you the explanation about the citadel, what is the purpose of it, at what time they built it, and when they built it, the mosque as well, and for who, like that.
Okay.
And kids.
Which one is mine? Dad, Dad, Joe.
What? Okay, दूसरी में चले जाएं.
No.
So right now we are inside the Cairo Citadel, also known as Salah al-Din al-Ayyubi Citadel. Salah al-Din, that was a sultan during the 1200, and he made that citadel to protect and defend Egypt from enemies such as the Crusaders at that time. And he built the citadel in the 1200. Later on, during the Turkish Empire by Muhammad Ali, he took that citadel like administrative place. So he made also a mosque, which is the one over there. It's known as green inside that mosque. So are you ready to see the mosque?
Yes, let's go.
the amazing thing with that mosque, we call it alabaster mosque because the material they are using to make the mosque using the alabaster, which is marble.
Marble.
Yeah.
Which is marble.
Yeah. Like you look here. That is alabaster. But that part is not smooth. But inside the mosque, you're gonna feel it. It's smooth, yeah. Shiny.
Alabaster.
Yeah.
So that whole alabaster.
These plastic keys, so you can
over the
wear it over the shoe.
Okay.
All right. So the first thing we saw at the entrance of Muhammad Ali Mosque is that place. We call it Sahel. Sahel is a place used to do the ablution. The ablution is like cleaning before the prayer. So the Muslim people, they pray 5 times per day. But before each prayer, they have to clean their body. For example, the arm until the elbow,
this area.
Behind the ears, yeah, because it has like tubes that provide water. But we don't use it anymore, we use the bathrooms outside and they come and enter. But back in the days, like in 1800 until 1900, that Sahel was in function, they were using it to do the ablution.
Okay.
Now we go inside the mosque and you're gonna see a lot of lamps. Now we are inside Muhammad Ali Mosque, and if you look here on the right side, that is the grave where is Muhammad Ali buried. There is about 300 lamps.
300 lamps?
Yeah, beside also the chandelier.
Wow.
There is a huge one over there. Also, if you look the art on the wall, like you can see the some verses from the Quran, and also La ilaha illallah, you can see it as well. And the one over there, that is the mimbar.
Anything else?
That's cool.
Let me walk.
Yeah, you can walk around, and after you finish, that is the exit door. I will be waiting you outside so we can give a look on the panoramic cavern. Alright?
Thank you so much. Someone left your ID card.
I am Dr. Khalid Masood. Wait.
Thank you.
الاجانب اللي هم مش عارفين حاجه عن الاسلام.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله
going through stamps.
What a cola coffee, cappuccino ice cream.
The Cairo here. Also, if they're like, it's not foggy, be careful. Don't go over there.
Gibran, don't. Get down. Both of you, get down. Get down.
And imagine if the sky is not foggy, not blazing like that, you could see the pyramids from here.
Thank you. Nee.